Hello everybody, I'm Markus Spangler here at Warwick. I'm taking care for Warwick for R&D and the Master Build Custom Shop instruments. And today we have a special bass here. That's the real Moon bass from Mike Ines of Alice in Chains, where I will take the measurements that we can build a replica for him. And Mike, it's still in good shape, because Mike was afraid a little bit that when it's coming to Germany that maybe it gets broken or whatever, but it's safe and everything is good. I hope we get close to the real one and make it happen, that it's satisfying Mike and also us, of course. And let's see what's inside and behind the bass.
I came upon like Warwick totally by accident. We were, this is back in 1990, early 1990, back in the Ozzy days. It was really nice, you know. So Ozzy's really good, when, especially when there's a new band member, and he'll spoil them, you know. He says, okay, I'm gonna buy you one or two instruments, and that's when you go for those kind of ones, right? So go to Manny's in New York. He said, just go pick out a couple basses for yourself, right? So I went to Manny's, and I walked in, and there's hundreds of basses up there. And so off in the corner, I don't think it's this one, but it looked almost exactly like this. It was off in the corner, and I said, told the guy to get a ladder out, and hey, what's that one up there? So he brought me my first streamer, and he set it in my hands, and I plugged it in, and as soon as I turned it up, it just had this distortion, this growl, you know. And it was the only bass out of all of them that when I plugged it in and really started slamming on it, that all the guys that worked at the place jumped on the Ampeg amp that I was playing through and turned it down, you know. It really had a good high output. So I said, okay, yeah, I'll take this one. And the Ozzy crew guys thought I was going to grab a few basses, you know, but I just came back with the one. I didn't like any of the other ones, so I just had the one streamer. I brought it back, and I was staying with Zach Wilde, and I was all proud of my new bass, you know. And you know, it's pretty expensive for a guy like me at the time. It was a couple $1,000s for this bass, you know. So I'm like, oh, Zach, look at my new guitar. And Zach looks at it, and he's like, oh, that's such a beautiful guitar. And then he takes it and then throws it down the hallway as hard as he could. He just slides it down this hallway and smashes it into this old school water heater, you know, heating up the hallway in the corner. I was like, oh my God, what's he doing? So I thought he wrecked my bass, but Zach's all, then he patted me on the back and started laughing. He's all, this thing is going to get so beat up, you don't even worry about it. It looks too new. He said it was like, you know, your best friend stepping on your new tennis shoes, you know. But it was so funny. So that before I even got to plug that thing into an amp for real, besides being in the music store, Zach Wilde had already threw it in a fucking wall, like about 40 feet down the hallway, you know. And so if it, I figured if it was if Zach Wilde, if it lasted, you know, with Zach throwing it around, it was a pretty tough bass. And to this day, 2016, 26 years later, that's still one of my best sounding basses, you know. There was one other, this one here, it's I call it a Moonburst. It's a silver burst kind of old bass. This is one of my best friends in the world, this bass. I was counting them up the other day. I played bass and performed in 50 countries at this point, and 49 or 50. I think we just did Singapore, was a new country that we just played, and I think that was the 50th country. So this bass and me have been through a lot of adventures together, you know. It's on its fourth headstock. The LA Oakland Raiders are my football team, so it's got a sticker up top with the Raider logo on it. That's not your typical Warwick thing. It's so beat up. The back bridge pickup doesn't even work. I don't even know when that quit working. My trusty tech, Scott, has said, oh, that never worked since I've been with you, and he's been with me 10 years straight now. So I don't know, not exactly sure when this quit working, you know. Basically, when I run everything, everything's full up on the basses anyway. So this has just been so beat up, and it's still my best sounding bass. Whenever I do records with this, the producers always come back to this bass, like, no, go back to the other one, you know. You know, I have a lot of probably 200 basses, 200 instruments or so, but this is the one still to this day. I just refuse to retire it until it falls apart on me. I'm just going to keep playing this. I just love it. It's my main bass. It's messed up here. I had a, God, what is it? I'd say 1995 or 98. I was in New Zealand playing with Ozzy, doing some arenas with Ozzy down there on a New Zealand, Australia, Japan tour. And I threw this to my tech, and the lights changed when the bass was in the air, and the thing smashed down here on this. And so, you know, I thought it was destroyed, and I wouldn't be able to use it. So Zach's tech at the time, his name was Franklin, and Franklin said, you know, I'm just going to put some glue on it, and we'll just fake it right now, because I didn't have very many backup basses at the time. And so he just kind of put it together like this, and you could see it. It's really messed up and still smashed in, and just a really bad glue job on it. So I used it for that tour, and it's still sounding fucking great, you know? I've never let anybody fix this bass. You could just see it's just smashed to shit, and it's just such a part of the history of it. I just really, really love this guy, and I just, every tech I get, they always want to, like, oh, we're going to resound this. Even Warwick was saying, hey, we'll redo it for you. It's like, no, it's good the way it is. This is just part of the history of it. You know, this bass is played, it's funny, I always say, I've jammed with everybody from Carrie Underwood to Kerry King from Slayer, Carrie to Carrie, everybody in between with this bass. You know, it's been 50 countries. You know, I've jammed with, you know, 5 years as a member of the band Heart, and so we do a lot of these country kind of sessions, you know. So I find myself jamming with like Dina Carter or Winona Judd or Carrie Underwood, you know, just and like Winona Judd, she loved this, you know. We were doing some country music, and that's the thing I love about a good bass tone will translate to any form of music, you know, whether it's you know, playing Pantera riffs at a benefit concert with Kerry King, or playing Winona Judd songs in Nashville with Heart and stuff. There wasn't a difference in the tone that much, you know, maybe a little more distortion and stuff when we're playing with Kerry and or Alice in Chains, for instance, or Ozzy. But the tone on Warwick's are just my favorite tone. They're so solid and just, it's like an old Chevy. I don't know if it's the German engineering of it, but they're just like an old Chevy truck. You just plug them in, turn them up, and they sound really, really good, you know? Yeah, I'm trying to talk to my trusty Warwick guys to redo these kind of older, kind of early 90s. But once again, the thing that I latch onto that I know I can count on every time is just a goddamn Warwick. You just plug the damn thing in, and it sounds great, you know? So it sounds good in the in-ear monitors. It's just like a Chevy truck. It's my go-to instrument, you know. I think it always will be, too. I've got a ton of great sounding basses, but there's just something about these Warwicks that really, translates, it just translates for me. And if I need that sound to go on an album, or if I need that sound to come out of a PA system and the subs out front and, like, Rock and Rio or something big like that, I could always count on these basses really cut through. They have a good cut, a lot of bottom end, and just the creamy distortion in the right areas. You know, we do a couple tricks, you know, out front to get certain frequencies to distort and things like that. But it's just so easy to work with it. The sound men love these Warwick basses, and they're just the best in the world for what I do anyways.